श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। JNTU के फाइनल ईयर ECE सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन यूनिट नंबर 3 लेक्चर नंबर 25 27 मई 2021 थर्सडे। सो टुडे सेशन डिजाइनिंग ऑफ डाउनलिंक्स पार्ट 3 डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ECE चेब्रोलू इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। Welcome to this online session. So today's session has discussion and explanation about link budget example, specially exclusive for C-band downlink for earth coverage beam. So this is the title for today's session. Let us start. So today's session involves with link budget for C-band downlink with earth coverage beam. So in this link budget, so we have this formula here. I place, so that equals to gain 3 dB bandwidth. So here we have 3 dB bandwidth . So now in this session, so here we are taking some steps recording link budget example. So yesterday, in previous session, so we formed some air link budget sheet, similarly rain link budget sheet. So from the same table, we are formatting some key points which are I am writing here. Step number one from the previous link budget sheet, so that equals to so from this sheet, so we have some important points I am writing here. So generally, this is the example belongs to the 24. How many transponders? What is the step one? 24 C-band transponders. 24 C-band transponders we have in our example. So that is first observation point here from the previous budget sheet. So all this link budget sheet has bandwidth. What is the bandwidth? So can anyone express? Yes, 36 megahertz. And another point here, what is the second point from this example? Similarly, here we have some downlink frequency. So here we have some downlink frequency. So the downlink band. So here I am writing the conclusion points to estimate the link value budget in a very simple manner. So downlink frequency equals to 3.7 to 4.2, which is here we have 3.7 to 4.2. Similarly, all circular polarization. So from this table, the observation point here I am writing that a satellite provide coverage of the visible earth, which subtended at an angle approximately. So here we have in this example, so we have 17 degrees subtended angle from a satellite into the geostationary orbit by using the global beam antenna. So this is the value important to form the link budget tabular form to enter the angle of satellite from a satellite towards in the particular geostationary orbit. Clear? So since this antenna beam width and gain are linked together, so we have a fundamental phenomena. So fundamental formula that we have. So 3 dB beam width. So beam width here not BW equal to beam width. So 33,000 divided by gain. So this is the empirical relationship shows the importance of relation between beam width and gain, where G is the ratio. So don't put this G in decibel. This is just numerical value. So since antenna beam width and gain, which are linked by this equation on axis gain of the global beam antenna, so when we are substituting all this gain in our example, so we have gain of 49 dB. So if you are estimating approximately, we are getting the 3 dB beam width that equal to 20 dB. So this link budget calculation for an earth station at the edge of coverage zone of the particular satellite, where the effective gain of this antenna is 3 dB lower. So how to estimate the good effective? Nothing but simple 3 dB down. So we have 17 dB version automatically find in our antenna beam width. So the channel to noise, carrier to noise ratio for this downlink is calculated in this tabular form for both the case air comma rain. So that we have to notice to estimate. So suppose, for example, here an antenna with gain 20 dB, already we have to track this 20 dB link budget. What are the specifications required for a satellite antenna? Here I am writing. So gain for the particular antenna equals to 20 dB. Similarly, effective aperture diameter. So we have effective aperture diameter, which is equals to 5.6. So how we can get 5.6? Nothing but we have the formula G equals to efficiency multiplied by pi diameter divided by lambda square. So by using this empirical relationship, so we have the diameter for our satellite antenna, which is equals to 0.42 meter. So this example is considered at a frequency of 4 gigahertz. Nothing but what is here, what is our discussion from this slide equals to, in this slide, we have a good knowledge on how to form the link budget for C-band. So this link budget C-band downlink calculations with coverage of the earth beam that should has, for this example, which is having gain 20 dB, already we solved here. So we have gain 20 dB and with effective aperture 5.6. So with the diameter 0.42 and frequency 4 gigahertz. So this calculation of channel to noise ratio is made with the center frequency of this 4 gigahertz. So now you should note down this as example. Now let me move on to the next slide. So saturated power output of the transponder. So next step to estimation, here I am writing saturated output power of this transponder equal to what? So 20, actually 20 minus 3, so therefore we have 17, but due to this saturation value here we are taking into dBW 13 dB, so conversions. So we will assume an output back of 2 dB, so that power transmitted by the transponder only 11 dB. So we are having this 2 dBW, so we are getting only 11 dBW, which is power transmitted by the transponder. So this is the power transmitted by the transponder. Here I am writing trans. So this is the way how to calculate the power transmitted by transponder, 11 dB, which is available from 13 dBW. Clear? Now next step. Hence an axis EIRP of this transponder and gain we have to calculating here. So we have the empirical formula that equals to PT GT. So PT GT equals to, what is the PT? We have 11 and gain 20. Yes, correct. So we have 31 dBW. So this is the observation number 2 and this is the observation number 1. But this transmitted signal is a single 30 megahertz bandwidth analog FM TV channel, whatever we presented in this band budget sheet example. Therefore, following the common practice for analog TV transmission, so therefore the TV receiver noise bandwidth is set to 27 megahertz actually from the 30 megahertz clear. So what is the, actually we need 30 mega, but 3 dB, three points are minimized, so 27 megahertz is the actual receiver noise bandwidth. So this is the receiver noise bandwidth. So the receiving earth station has an antenna with aperture diameter in our previous slide 9 meter and the gain 47 at 4 gigahertz. Now what is, how to calculate the G/2 ratio for the earth station? Now the next parameter we have to calculating here, G/T ratio. So all active listeners carefully observed for each step, very important for our literature link budget. So next step, G/2 ratio for this earth station. How to calculate? Can anybody has knowledge on this G/T ratio? Yes. So our previous value, which is from 49.7 and minus. So we have to calculate the noise. So how do we have to calculate? What are the requirements we have? Diameter 9 mm, gain for our example 49.7 dB, and recurrence frequency for 4 gigahertz. So by using this data in our calculator, we have system noise temperature that equal to 75 K. So now I am substituting in this one. So here our formula 10 log 10 75, don't forget. So what is the answer in our calculators? 30.9 dBK. So this is the actual G/T ratio required for our satellite, 39 dBK. So once again, you can mentioned all this required output. So this is the first output answer, and the Roman number 2 answer, and the Roman number 1 answer. So these are required for our final budget evaluation sheet. We have to edit all these values in the final budget evaluation sheet. And so that's why here I am placing in the some specific red color. Now, what is the fourth observation? What is the fourth task we have to calculate? So we have to calculate the same at the C band. We have to know propagation loss is very small, but the slant path through this atmosphere will suffer a typical attenuation. Let's take 0.2 dB in the clear air. So we have to notice the attenuation also. So here I am writing that attenuation value, so which is very small in our previous table, 0.2 dB. So we will allow an additional 0.5 dB margin for this link design to account for the miscellaneous losses if there are any occurring on this midpoint polarization mismatching or any degree calculations for this link budget value. So now let us move. What is the next step we have to encounter? So another observation here I made here, the earth station receiver channel to noise ratio. First, here we have to calculate the value which are be available from this point, nothing but in the clear air. So we have to estimate the values in clear air. So in the clear air, the minimum permittivity over channel to noise ratio for this link design, in our previous example, we have only 9.5 dB. Clear? From this point, this value taken from our previous link budget sheet. So don't confuse. And corresponding to this value, next step we have to calculate the downlink channel to noise ratio, which we already calculated 16 dB in clear air. So we have already calculated in the previous step, that is in air we have 16 dB C by N. So that shows link margin of 6.5 dB. Now, can anybody guess how to calculate the temperature? So that is the sky temperature at 273 Kelvin. So next step, we have to calculating sky temperature, that equal to T sky. What is the T sky value here at 273? So 273 multiplied by S1 minus 1 by, we have empirical formula na, simple substitution, so that will have 66 Kelvin. So this is our observation number 5. In clear air, the sky noise temperature is just about 13K. So the result of 0.2 dB of clear air attenuation. So therefore, noise temperature of the receiving system has therefore updated value on this noise temperature, that is having 66 minus 13. So we have only 53 Kelvin. So 53K is the minimum. How to calculate the maximum? 53 plus older 75 na. So we have 128K. So don't forget. So this is our sixth link budget parameter. So therefore, from this discussion, noise temperature for this receiving system has increased by 53K to 128K. So for this example, what is the rain attenuation? Can anybody guess? Yes, 1 dB is the perfect rain attenuation in the slant path direction from the clear air, and the value at 75K. So this is the reason how to increase the noise temperature of 2.3 dB in our previous link budget sheet. Now we can just adjust this link budget very easy to account for heavy rain as well as the slant path without having the recalculation phenomena. So therefore, channel to noise ratio from the beginning. So the received power is reduced by how much value? Can anybody guess? That is just 1 dB attenuation enough to maintain the rain attenuation and the system noise temperature. Therefore, system noise temperature incremental goes to just 3.2 dB over the minimum permissible value. So now next, what is the another conclusion from the same information? If the channel to noise ratio has margin of this 3.2 dB over the minimum permissible C by N, therefore overall gain can be reduced to how much? Yes, correct. 9.5 dB value. Already here I mentioned 9.5 dB. So these values are very important. We have to recalculate it just by using like in our channel to noise ratio, which are be participating in the previous example. Now from this discussion, we have a conclusion. From this discussion, we have conclusion that the reduction in the air at the station antenna, just it has 1.2 dB is the perfect attenuation required for making the value just 1.32. So therefore, antenna gain is proportional to diameter of square, that equals to diameter of earth station can be reduced by how much factor? Just a simple square for this value. We have previous 1.32 now, that equals to 1.15. So see here observation. So nothing but just drop to 9 meter to 7.8 meter. So therefore, see how the how a practical antennas are minimized. How practical antennas are minimized while calculating this antenna measurements as well as the antenna shapes also. Another point here I have to explain with you that global beam antennas are not widely used, although the most of the satellites which are in worldwide or having the Intelsat satellites, we have to carry them through the ground earth orbits. So that is the point here we have to mentioned. So very regional TV signal transmission. Sometimes suppose we have to calculate the gain for a typical satellite antenna providing the earth coverage area of 32. So how to calculate the particular gain? Yes, we have already previous formula, that equal to 3300 divided by theta half plane and phi half plane. So in this way also directly gain should be evaluated for this type of antenna earth stations, which is just 12 dB higher than on axis gain of global beam. So dear participants, so with this session knowledge, using this link budget in this tabular forms, we can trade off this tabular forms just 12 dB gain over the regional coverage satellite for the reduction of earth stations and the antenna users phenomena. So this in this way we have to recalculated the entire parameters that we have to posted in this C-band geo satellite link design sheet. So this example shows how the link budget can be used to study the different combinations of system parameters like gain, power, bandwidth, CNR, beam width, noise temperatures, back off periods, edge of beam losses, sky losses, margin losses, all these system temperature parameters are be recalculated by using same procedure in our C-band link design formations. Clear? And most of the satellite links analysis don't have yield that wanted results at the first try. So therefore, designers or any analyst, they must use this link budget to adjust the system parameters until an acceptable results are achieved. So we have a greater, more examples in the link budgets that are included in various books. Just you go through the link budgets, so you have a good knowledge command on this formation of link budget. So based upon this knowledge, let us try to solve a simple parameter power equations numerically. So here I mentioned some power equations. So here we are having power equations which are be utilized regularly in the satellite earth communication system. So now I am here link budget expressions which are be numerically. So in this slide we have some brief conclusion, the final formulas which are several times asked in the end examination. So we have the received signal power formula PT GT GR divided by PL LR TLR. So whatever all mentioned parameters we are already crossed in the previous lectures. So in the numerator, PT, transmitted output power, units are watts, GT, transmitted gain, GR, receiver gain, propagation loss, PL, LR, receiver loss, transmitter LT. So by using this example, the free space transmission loss, where D is the diameter or distance from the ground to satellite, lambda is the wavelength. So same propagation loss may also be formulated in another alternative form, 4 pi distance by lambda square. So just to try to substitute this value in equation number 1, so we got PR equals to PT GT GR divided by 4 pi d by lambda square LR LT. So this is the received power equation. So try to practice. Similarly, our received power may also has another format which we explained in previous classes, PTZT minus LT minus PT minus LR plus gain. So you have to make a command on this empirical formula. They may ask it several times in our end examinations. So likewise, same another alternating form for PR. So same thing we have to calculate it. So this is another example I mentioned from same explanation where we got gain, where we got a small gain, approximately 20 dB. So in addition, for this extra 60 dB, we have to adjust the propagation loss by using this empirical formula. Therefore, for free space propagation, so the receiver power may also has updated form PTGT minus LT plus GR minus LR minus 20 log D minus 20 log F minus 32.45. So try to take snapshot. We have limited time to note down all. So take snapshot. Thank you for everyone who are active participating in this online session. So today we got good knowledge on how to format link budget sheet, how to update and how to recalculate it, and how to edit the numericals in the available link sheet. So it is easy to convenient for the scientist to launch the space vehicles with this all satellite link budget. So in the next session, we will be with you with another new topic in the satellite communication. Thank you for everyone.